The following is a Thorf TV production brought to you in cooperation with Jack Thorfinson. Ladies and gentlemen, it's time once again for the SOCS Show, brought to you live from Mr. Holster's Ranch, way up north near the Canadian border. Let's have a big round of applause for that unique YouTube personality. Direct from the bar, here he comes, Mr. Holster! You gotta be kidding me, Jack. Unique? Yeah, I'll say he's unique. But as unique. Oh, Mr. Holster! Hey! Howdy, Parja! It's me, Mr. Holster. What have we got tonight? Ooh, Sazerac. Hey, didn't we have this last week? Well, I'm not gonna complain. I like Sazerac. It's my favorite, Jack. I'm sorry. Take that back. Don't worry about it. Sazerac rye, straight rye whiskey. 90 proof, 45%. Alcohol by content. This rye whiskey is the perfect choice. Yeah, it is, Jack. Thank you. Thank you very much. Let's pop the top on this one, as Machine Gun Kelly would say. Ah. Oh. Well, I'd like to say I deserve this. It's been a tough week, but this has been one of the best weeks of my life, so I am not gonna say that. Yeah, take another whiff. I'll give you another one. Real cork, by the way. Nothing but the best with Sazerac rye. And of course, this is made by the same company that makes Pappy Van Winkle. Pappy Van Winkle, if you're into bourbon, you know what I'm talking about. Oh, yeah. Well, let's put a little in the old ranch shot glass. West Texas dust. Just a little, Jack, because I'm a little giddy as it is. I don't want to get carried away. All things in moderation. But I am going to put the cork back in right away. I don't want any evaporation to happen and lose any of that good stuff. Ooh, Sazerac's rye. To the sunny slopes of long ago. Now, if that doesn't heat you up and cool you down all at the same time. Oh, yeah. I feel great. I woke up this morning and had breakfast in bed. Yeah, I fell asleep at the breakfast table. I was out the other night with my wife and her mother. And her mother said to the bartender, "Can you make me a zombie?" And the bartender looked at her and said, "I'm sorry, ma'am, God beat me to it." Which is so, it's not even funny, it's so true. My wife drives me nuts. When we got married, she said she was afraid of the dark. And our honeymoon, I got undressed with the lights on, and now she's afraid of the light. You know, Mr. Holster has not had an easy life. When I grew up, it was so tough when I was a kid growing up. I used to say to my dad, "Can we go to the zoo? Can we go to the zoo? Can we go to the zoo?" Finally, he said to me, "Hey, listen, kid, if they want you, they'll come and pick you up." Well, there you go. There we go, guys. Let's have a little chaser of some Diet Coke to wash the old Sazerac rye down. Give it a good ending. Oh, yeah. I like that. Mm-mm. Well, Jack, I see you had another date last night. That's two Thursdays in a row. Did you enjoy yourself? A little bit? Jack got the Spitfire out last night, and he went on a date, and he must have had fun, because he didn't come home till 4 in the morning, but he doesn't want to talk about it. Seriously, Jack, where'd you go? What? Wow. Well, excuse me, Jack. That was a little... I'm sorry, I won't pry. We'll let it go. this is what we have tonight. If you saw the title of the video, we're going to talk about my Speed 6. And this is part of the 6, the 3 6's, which is interesting. The 3, triad, the 3. 6's, 6, 6, 6. You see? Kind of scary. I know. That always gets me. And I had a gun once upon a time. And I had it for a while, and my luck kind of turned south, and you know, I actually took a real hit trading that gun for something else, but the serial number started with 666. And it just, yeah, and when I got rid of it, the day I got rid of it, everything turned around for me. It's something to think about. Anyway, this gun here is my Speed 6, which is part of the 3 6's I'm talking about, which is the Service 6, Police Service 6. Well, let's start at the beginning. The Security 6, then the Police Service 6, and then the Speed 6. And how that worked was, originally Ruger brought out the Security 6, and within a year and a half, or maybe less, they decided they needed to... The original Security 6 was made in, was available in an adjustable sight or a fixed sight like this, which is just a groove in the frame and your metal sight mounted on the front of the barrel. And they made the original Security 6 either way, and somebody at Ruger got the brilliant idea, which was probably a good idea. Somebody in marketing said, we should really come out with a version just in the fixed sights called the Police Service 6 to sell to law enforcement and security agencies. Yeah, that's what they did. And of course, you could get the Police Service 6 in, if you were a police department or security company, you could buy it in the fixed sights or the adjustable sights. Either one. So it was really, and there's a lot of Security 6's bouncing around that are adjustable sights or fixed sights too. But when they did that, they decided they had a butt on the gun that was quite similar to this, pretty identical, pretty close. They decided to make this more of a square butt because that seemed to be what everybody wanted, and they did that. And then they had the Security 6 and the Police Service 6. You following me? Okay. Then the law enforcement community said, well, you know, can you give us a gun for our plainclothes operatives? And so what they did is they brought out the Speed 6, and they put that, they took that little bump, that square grip off, and made it more rounded, a lot akin to the original version of the Security 6 for plainclothes operatives. A lot of these guns were sold to agencies like, well, it's not really an agency, but it is. They're investigators, the Postal Department, yeah, and a lot of detectives carried, believe it or not, carried this model. And this is my old Speed 6, and I got this out tonight because somebody offered to buy this from me, and I'm actually contemplating this because they offered me $800 for this gun, and I'm thinking, you know, it's just sitting in the cabinet. It's one of those ones I don't use anymore. Because even Mr. Holster, the old revolver guy, has moved on to other things. Yeah, mostly automatics, I'll admit it. Yeah, I'll admit that. Mostly automatics. Of course, I still favor the double action only 6.42 or the LCR in the ankle holster if you're going for backup. And that brings another topic of conversation up, and I'm going to discuss this real quick because I made a video not long ago that was, and I'll put a link to it right up here. Yeah, it's a John Full. Anyway, we won't talk about that. It's kind of... Anyway, I'll put a link to it up there. And in that video, I talk about the importance of carrying a revolver for backup. And I had some flack on the comments section on that. about the need of a backup, like you need a backup. Well, and this is what I'm going to say to that right now to clear that up. Most of the comments reflected around, well, you don't need a backup. Most gunfights are only two rounds and you put them down and it's all over. So why would you need a backup? That's just stupid. Okay, let me go back to the reason you carry a gun. And it goes back to one of my favorite, it's not a movie, it was actually a miniseries, Lonesome Dove, where Captain McCall says to Newt, gives him a gun, and he says, it's better to have it and not need it than to need it and not have it. And then my dad used to say that all the time. He used to drum that into my head. And if you think you need to carry a gun because something might happen, because quite frankly, the chances of you going out in public and needing to have a gun, concealed carry, no, they're like astronomical. It'll never happen. You don't need that gun. You're wasting your time and your effort. And so if you believe you need to get a gun and carry it, you see where I'm going with this? The chances, and this is what the arguments were from these people, the chances of needing a backup gun are like astronomical. Well, chances of needing the gun to start with are astronomical. And I'll go back to Leroy Thompson, who has one of the favorite quotes of my lifetime is his, that says the fastest reload on a firearm is a second firearm. Yeah, there you go, your backup gun. So that's my answer to all those people. And really, I didn't answer them. I just went, eh, you know. Eh. Yeah, but yeah. Anyway, where was I? Now I've gone far astray, like Mr. Holster always does. Go off on a tangent. Yeah, so I'm looking at this gun and thinking, well, I don't use it that much. It's got some sentimental value, but I got so many things in my life that have sentimental value. You got to be kidding me. And that's one thing I learned a long time ago, that sentimental value is good to a point. Yeah. So yes, I'm actually contemplating. The only thing that slows me down is I have so many holsters for this, so many nice ones that cost so much money. You see what I'm saying? And of course I could get one of those brand new Colts, the Colt Cobra, but if you've watched or you've heard any of the news, they laid off a bunch of people at Colt, and you know, I'm thinking, I wouldn't bet any money on that actually showing up. I don't know. But I can go back to, I bought a match pair of Colt single action armies one time on a rumor that Colt had locked their doors. They locked their doors, they locked the workers out, they're going down and out, it's over. And I ran out and I bought two single action armies, a match pair, and yeah. No, they're still in business. That was back in like 2002. So, you know, that stuff doesn't mean anything. Just thought I'd say that. So there you have it. I thought I'd just bring this out and talk about it because I got offered $800 for this thing, and I don't really know what they're worth. I know I paid somewhere around $200 for it. I'm not really sure. It's a long time ago. And it's got sandbar stag grips, which I paid $69 for. I remember that. And they really are nice. I love the bark on it. It has very nice bark. Yeah, very nice bark. That was your cue, Jack. He thinks it's demeaning to talk like that. Any rate, and what that does, it's the bark is the black, yeah, or the dark brown. Not really black. Dark brown areas. And it just gives you such a nice grip on this gun. I've always enjoyed it. But frankly, I don't use it much anymore. It was really just a backup gun in that shoulder, upside down shoulder holster all those years. Yeah, it was just a backup gun when I was working in the private sector. But at any rate, I am contemplating that because, yeah. I thought I'd share that with you and eat up 14 minutes and 47 seconds of your life you'll never, ever, ever get back. Before I leave you, this is the part where you think I'm going to talk about my giveaway. No, I'm not. I want to talk about a gentleman, and I see a lot of you have subbed to him, and I appreciate that. Thank you. But I'm going to talk one more time in case there's some of my subs out there that may have missed that video, and I'll put a link right up here to that video. Yeah, there we go. John Travolta, it's, yeah, I know. Yeah. Any rate, put a link to that video, and I'm talking about a gentleman I know, a young man who's very knowledgeable about firearms and lived down in Hawaii and left his family and moved to Arizona because there were firearms he wanted to buy and magazines that he couldn't down there because they're kind of anal retentive about their firearms down there. And there's no real shooting ranges worth anything to go to, and he wanted to shoot. Yeah, so he moved to Arizona, and he's trying to start his life over again. And if he could go sub this guy, well, it's already gone now, but if you go sub him, I'd appreciate it. Give him a little support. Watch his commercials so he gets a little income to help him out get started. Get off of that, and we'll go right to what you're waiting for. Well, you're probably not waiting for it, but I'm going to it anyways. My giveaway. Yes, I am having a giveaway, and it's called the American Gunfighter 5,000 Sub Giveaway, where you can win a $350 gift certificate to Brownells, where you can go and buy ammo, gun parts, magazines. You can even buy yourself a gun. Yeah. With that $350 gift certificate. And you can also buy AR parts. You could, if you're doing a build, think of it. You can get yourself a nice upper. Yeah, all that. If you win, and all you have to do right now to get in my contest is, number one, be a subscriber. Number two, like this video. And number three, in the comments section down below, just type in, nice Ruger there, Mr. Holster. Thank you. Thank you very much. I think it is too. But maybe it's time for it to move on to new hands. Thanks for tuning in, guys. If you like my channel, please subscribe. Till the next time, Jack and I want you to go out and stay safe. 17 minutes and 43 seconds of your life, you'll never get back again.